Hey everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to give you some tips and tricks on how to enhance the performance of your SkinGen plugin for Character Creator 3. This is particularly useful for those of us who may be using less high-end machines and need to free up resources in order to boost the speed of our program. Let's start off with a look at the minimum requirements. You can find this on the website as well. Keep in mind that these are the bare minimum, and you'll definitely want to have hardware beyond this to achieve the recommended results. Here are the recommended requirements. Please note that a larger RAM capacity is very important for simultaneous processing of different tasks while customizing your character. We also recommend installing Character Creator and its content on a solid-state drive if possible, in order to increase the input-output operations per second. A better graphics card is also extremely important, as this will allow for smoother movement when adjusting parameter sliders for various properties. If we take a look at the 4K editing recommendations, you'll see that you'll want to have at least 6GB of video memory with a graphics card newer than the NVIDIA GTX 900 series or Radeon R9 300 series. Okay, let's dig into the preference settings first. Under the Dynamic Texture Editor section, there's an option to show or hide your character's clothing and accessories when you enter Edit Skin mode. If we activate our editor with this enabled, you can see that there is a nearly 8GB commit size for this particular project, which will put a huge strain on lower-end systems. Let's go back and deactivate that option and try again. This time you'll notice the clothing and accessories will disappear once we enter skin edit mode, and the commit size has been reduced significantly to 6.6 GB. There is also an option to warn when your memory is low. You can set the memory allocation amount, and if your operation exceeds that amount, it will pop up with a warning message. Let's apply a level of dirt on the skin here, and you'll notice that due to our settings there, the message will pop up and ask us to flatten the motion layers before proceeding. Next, let's take a look at enabling Direct Draw Surface Cache, or DDS. This is the folder that Character Creator 3 will temporarily use when activating the skin edit mode. What you want to do ideally is have this folder on an SSD with a larger capacity. Let's take a look at how effective that is by entering into skin edit mode for the first time and timing it with our stopwatch. You'll see that it takes nearly 55 seconds to load the first time, and the cache folders are all created on your SSD. Each folder contains separate files that will be used by Character Creator 3 to load skin edit mode faster next time. You can see an example right here. So now that these cache folders containing the temp data are all on our SSD, the second time we load will be a lot faster. You'll see that the second time we load skin edit mode, it will be a lot faster at 36.28 seconds due to the cache data. If you find that the cache data is too high, you can manually delete it all by selecting Clear Cache button. The cache data will also automatically be deleted once it exceeds 150 GB. Let's take a look now at enhancing layer performance while adjusting parameters. Notice that when I drag some of these parameters here, there's a slight lag between the position of the slider and the effect on the screen. You'll also see our commit size in the task manager is nearly at 7GB. One of the easiest ways to reduce the amount of resources your layers use is to reduce the texture resolution. Here we're taking it down to 512 by 512. There'll be a noticeable reduction in quality for that layer, but you'll also notice that the slider performance is much quicker. The commit size has also been reduced considerably to under 6GB now as well. With the latest update, you no longer need to manually set each layer to a different resolution. All you need to do is select the material area that you want to change, and then click the update button beside the resolution you choose. This will update all layers in that material to the same resolution, and drastically reduce the commit size to just over 3GB in this case. However, this will only apply to the current material that you are using. Other materials like the body, hands, and legs need to be updated separately. When you have the results you want after editing, just switch it back to 2048 by 2048 for optimal visual quality. Flattening your layers is also a good way to increase system performance, as well as speed up loading in the appearance editor. Let's take a look at the difference by loading up the appearance editor on this character and timing it. You'll see it comes in at 51 seconds. If we select the sculpt layer, we can scroll down and see all the parameter sliders below. Once you flatten your layers, you'll no longer be able to operate these sliders, so keep that in mind. We're going to take a look at the flatten and make static options here, both of which essentially do the same thing. However, you can easily reverse the make static option by making it dynamic again, which we'll talk about a little bit later. If we select the body hair layer of the body material and scroll down, you can see that there are plenty of body parameter sliders here as well. If we select flatten all materials on our character, these will also be flattened as well, as we'll see in a moment. Let's go back to the head material now and choose flatten all materials. Once we do this, you'll see that all the adjustment parameters for our layers have now disappeared, and all of the values have been baked into our texture maps. If we go to the body material, we'll see the same thing, where all the sliders have now disappeared. This saves your system resources for quicker operation, and it also increases the speed at which your appearance editor will load. If we activate the appearance editor one more time, you'll see that it will now load up in 36 seconds, a lot quicker than before. Let's start off with the unflattened character again, and take a look at Make Static. Make Static is essentially the same as flattening the materials, however it can easily be reversed. We have the option to apply this on a layer-by-layer basis, but let's try the entire head material first. If we do that and select Current Material, you'll see the same results on all of your different layers, as if they've all been frozen. This is done to conserve memory resources when you're editing, but when you still may have more adjustments to do on those layers in the future. There is a message at the top that notifies you that you can reverse this static mode at any time by using the Make Dynamic function. Let's give this a shot, this time only for the single scalp layer. You'll notice that when we select this, that now all the parameters have been restored, and we can fully customize all aspects of the scalp once again. Let's take a look at merging layers now. The head material on this character has 8 layers, including the skin base layer, which everything else can be merged into. You can see performance right now is at 6GB commit size. Let's apply this beard template to our character to add a couple more layers into the mix, which will increase the commit size. Now you'll see there are 10 layers, since 2 have been added on, and the commit size is at 7GB. We have a couple of merge options as well. Let's take a look at Merge Visible first. What this will do is merge all the layers that are currently visible on our character. If we look at the skin base layer right now, you can see that the base color map is fairly basic, and we don't have the beard baked into that yet. Let's hide the beard base and scalp layers and take a look at the commit size. It's now slightly less at 6.3 gigabytes. I'm going to continue on to merge the visible layers for the current material, and now you'll see that all the other maps have been baked into the skin base color texture map, and commit size has been reduced to 5.6 gigabytes. If I select the merge down option, then every single layer will be baked into the skin base layer, regardless of whether it is visible or not. You can see the base color map displaying all of this baked data here. One important thing to note here is that when merging layers in makeup mode, these layers will also be merged into the skin base layer. Here I'm merging these eyebrow makeup layers, and you can see now that all the data will be merged into the skin base layer under skin. So that's about it for this tutorial, guys. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope you check out all of our other SkinGen tutorials, and also check out our forums at forum.reallusion.com for more info. I'll see you in the next video.